Okay, so in my last video I talked about how we can create our first C# program in Visual Studio. Now let us start exploring more about C#. So let us talk about C# data types. Okay, so as like other programming languages, we had various data types like your int, character, float, boolean, double, many more. Okay, likewise on the same line, C# also have many data types. Okay, and almost the data types are common in between most of the programming languages. Okay, so let me switch to Visual Studio, and this was my first program over here. Now the very first data type we have is boolean. Okay, so boolean data type is represented with bool. Okay, so here it is, bool is a keyword. Okay, so bool, that means if you see bool anywhere, that means it is your boolean data type. Okay, now what is your data type? Your data type is nothing but, so you, if you want to store any data into some variable, that variable should be assigned with some data type. So what that data type will indicate? Data type will indicate what type of data is present into particular variable. Okay, so bool, I'll give some variable, is it me? Okay, so the variable name is it me. Okay, and what could be the possible values for boolean? For boolean it could be true or false. Okay, so I'll just write it as a true. Okay, so that's it. This is how you can use your boolean data type. Okay, bool and your local variable name, whatever variable it is, and its value could be either true or false. Okay, so bool is in, it's very straightforward. What next we have? We have next byte. Okay, so here you can see byte is my keyword. Okay, byte, if I hover my mouse, you can see the description represents an 8-bit unsigned integer. Okay, so if it is 8-byte unsigned integer, that means it will store in between 0 to 255. Okay, so 8-bit means what? 8 bits is nothing but 2 raised to power 8. Okay, that means 255. Okay, so if you go to this C# Microsoft documentation, so here you will find all the details about this data types. Okay, so I was talking about byte. Okay, so for byte you can see it is 8-bit and it ranges from 0 to 255. Okay, so all these things, like whether it is byte, whether it is short, int or long, all are used to store your integer. Okay, so let us say I have some requirement where I want to store some number. Okay, I want to store some number which is my 899 or something, some number. Okay, so normally what we use, normally we use int I is equal to 99, something we use like this. So normally we are fan of using int, okay, which is integer. Okay, and integer, you can see the description, it is represents 32 bit signed integer. Okay, so what this 32 bit means? 32 bit, that means 2 raised to power 32, that means it comes close to this. Okay, so you can if it is some average number, you can go with int. Okay, if it is very long number, very huge number, then you can go with data type as long. Long number is equal to something like this. Okay, if you are not sure about your number length, if it can be huge, then you can go with this data type long. Okay, so all these data types, whether it is long, whether it is integer, whether it is short, or whether it is byte, all are used to store numeric data. Okay, now you must be seeing two things over here, signed integral and unsigned integral. Okay, so signed integral, that means it store your numbers negative and positive both. Okay, so if it is, if I give int, okay, if I use int, it is signed integral, sign integer, that means it can store your negative value as well as positive value. So it can hold a value in between minus this 2 plus this. Whereas if it is unsigned integer, if you define it as a uint, then it can holds the value in between 0 to 429, whatever it is. Okay, so it gets doubles than this. Okay, so if you are confirmed, okay, my number will never be negative, negative value will never come to my this particular variable, particular integer, then you can use uint. But the ideal practice what we use is we use simply int. Okay, and if the number is a number can be huge, then we go with long. Okay, so that's what we can use this data type for your numeric. If your number is very short, if it can be in between 0 to 1 255, then you can use byte. If it is short number, a very small number but bigger than this byte, and if you are sure if it can be in between this and this, then only you can go with this byte and use short. Otherwise normally we go with this 32 bit which can holds the value in this range. Okay, and if you can expect a huge value, then we should go with long. Okay, so this was about numbers. Okay, and what else we have? We have floating point, so we have float and double. So if your program expect some value with decimal point, okay, decimal value is equal to 3.14. okay, if your variable is expected to hold a decimal point value, value contains decimal, then you can use this double or float. Okay, so the difference again here, it is number of bits. Okay, floats holds a bit lesser value than your, not bit, double, it doubles actually, and double, in fact it doubles the value of your float. Okay, so float is 32 bit, double is 64 bit, and here you can find the range. Okay, so the range is too huge. Okay, 10^324 to 10^308, too huge. Okay, we cannot imagine it even. So float and doubles are used whenever you want to store value containing decimal. Fine, so these are three straightforward data types: boolean, your integer to store numeric value, and we have double and we have float as well to store your value with decimal. Okay, and you can use the value on the similar line wherever you want to use it. We will be just referring this variable name so that this value will get called. Okay, so this is all about the data types. Okay, so these and all data types are used in C#. Okay, along with this there are few more data types. Let me see if I have that information on this page. Okay, so there are two types of data: value types and reference type. Okay, so value type is nothing but you are directly assigning the value, like how we did. We directly assigned the value I is equal to 99. We directly assigned the value. But there are something called as reference types as well. Okay, and what are the reference type? We have object, we have string, we have enum, we have arrays, we have delegates. So all those things comes under your reference type. Okay, so we'll be talking about this reference data types in detail, because this string itself is a huge concept, interface again it's a huge concept, so we'll be having separate videos for all of them. Okay, but for now this is just how we can declare the variable and we can assign the respective data type. Okay, one more thing, let us say if you want to check the maximum value that int can store. Okay, so how you can get this? So you can get it like int dot. Okay, so as soon as you click on int, after int, as soon as you click a dot, you can get number of methods. Okay, so what are these methods? Equals, max value, mean value. Okay, so here you can see we got two things over here, constants and methods in it. Okay, so this max value and mean value are the constant. Okay, so if you want to find out what are the max value int can store, just hold the have this, it will give you the max value which int can store. Okay, and if you just want to get a mean value, again we have the option for that, get a mean value. Okay, so this will give you the mean value, right? So by using this number you can get the max and mean value. So you must have noticed, like, as soon as I typed int, okay, and I can access the number of methods, properties, constants, whatever it is. Okay, so what this means is, in C sharp everything is object. Okay, so whatever I type, it is object. Okay, so whatever there is in C sharp, everything is object. That makes C sharp as a pure object oriented programming. Okay, so that's all about this data types. Okay, so in next few videos we'll be talking about a string, and what else we have? We have some decision makings, we have some loops, we have some methods, arrays, we enums, and after that we have various object oriented programming concepts like your polymorphism, method overloading, operator overloading, constructors. So we'll be talking about all of them. Okay, so fine, thank you.